Welcome to the second video on the Law of Sines. This video deals with the ambiguous case, so the goal is to solve triangles using the Law of Sines given side-side angle. So the Law of Sines has a problem dealing with side-side angle. If you are given two sides and one angle, the Law of Sines could provide 0, 1, or 2 solutions. A couple things we need to remember before we start is the sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. The sine function will only return values in the closed interval from negative 1 to 1. And lastly, if sine theta is between 0 and 1, theta can lie in the first quadrant as an acute angle and also in the second quadrant as an obtuse angle. Let's take a look at the conditions that must be present to have two solutions. In this sketch, if the length of side B is given, and the length of side A is given, as well as the measure of angle A, we'd have side-side angle. So that's the first condition to have two possible solutions, side-side angle. Second, the given angle A must be acute. Third, this side A must be less than side B. And fourth, side A is longer than the altitude. This side A must be greater than this length here. Remember, you can think of this as the height of the triangle, so this length A must be greater than this height here. If all these statements are true, then angle B, this one here, could be acute, as we see here in the dashed triangle, and it could also be obtuse, as we see here in the solid triangle. Let's take a look at an animation that illustrates this. So here we have a triangle, and notice as I change the length of B, here we see it has two solutions because this length B is less than side A, but greater than the height of this triangle, which would be the altitude of the triangle. So if the length of B is between the height of the triangle, but less than this other known side, we can have two solutions. If it's too small or less than the height, we actually have no solutions because we can't connect the three sides to form a triangle. And if the length of side B is too large, again, there's two solutions, but once it becomes larger than side A, we only have one possible triangle. Okay, so obviously that is a lot to remember, but here's what you really need to know. Number one, if you have side-side angle and the given angle is acute, you could have 0, 1, or 2 possible triangles. If, when using the law of sines, you get an equation where sine theta is greater than 1, then there's no solution. Number 3, if, when using the law of sines, you get an equation where sine theta is less than 1, we will find both the acute and obtuse angle for that equation. And then we'll just use those two angles to check to see if we can form a triangle with both angles. And the way we do this is, remember, the sum of the interior angles can't be greater than 180 degrees. So if the obtuse angle is possible, we will have two solutions. If the obtuse angle is not possible, then we'll only use the acute angle and have one solution. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Notice we have side-side angle. Let's go ahead and record the given information. So angle C is 82 degrees, side A is 11 meters, and side C is 7 meters. Let's go ahead and apply the law of sines and see what happens. Let's try to determine the measure of angle A. So we have the sine of 82 degrees is to the opposite side 7 meters as the sine of A divided by 11. We have a proportion with one unknown. Let's go ahead and cross multiply. 7 sine A must equal 11 sine 82 degrees. Divide both sides by 7. Let's go ahead and evaluate this on our calculator. I'm already in degree mode. 11 sine 82 degrees divided by 7. We have approximately 1.5561. Remember, the sine function only returns a value on the closed interval from negative 1 to positive 1. Sine A cannot equal 1.5561. This is an indication that there is no solution to this problem. Go ahead and take a look at another problem. Let's set up our triangle. Angle A is 88 degrees, side A is 110 feet, side C is 54 feet. Again, we have side-side angle, the given angle is acute. Let's go ahead and apply the law of sines and see what happens. So we have to use angle A and side A, sine of 88 degrees over 110 must equal Let's try to find angle C. So we have the sine of C divided by 54. Cross multiply, solve for sine C. And just to save some time, I've already found this value. It's approximately 0.4906. Let's go ahead and find one possible value for C. We'll find the value of inverse sine 0.4906. This gives us an angle of approximately 29 degrees. But there's also another angle that has the sine function value of 0.4906. Remember, sine is positive in both the first and the second quadrant. So if we have a 29 degree angle here, if we sketch a 29 degree reference angle in the second quadrant, this angle will have the same sine function value. This would be 180 minus 29 degrees, or 151 degrees. The question becomes, is it possible for angle C to also be 151 degrees? It's actually not, because remember, we already know that angle A is 88 degrees. Well, 88 degrees plus 151 degrees is obviously larger than 180 degrees, which is the sum of the interior angles of any triangle. So even though this returns the same sine function value, it's not a possible angle for this triangle. So we will only have one solution to this problem. Let's go ahead and label angle C as 29 degrees. We can find the remaining angle because we know the sum must be 180 degrees. So 180 minus 29 minus 88 will give us 63 degrees for angle B. Now to find the length of side B, we are going to have to use the law of sines again. So to get started, let's use angle A and side A. Sine of 88 degrees divided by 110 must equal the sine of 63 degrees divided by B. Cross multiply, divide by sine 88, so we have B is approximately 98 feet. So we had one that had no solution. Here's one that has one solution. Let's take a look at the third possibility. So angle B is 40 degrees. Length of B is 22 centimeters, and the length of A is 30 centimeters. Using the law of sines, let's try to determine the measure of angle A. So we'll have the sine of B, or the sine of 40 degrees, divided by 22, must equal the sine of A divided by 30. Cross multiply, divide by 22. And again, to save time, I've already found this value to be approximately 0.8765. So A is approximately equal to inverse sine 0.8765. Let's go to our calculator. Inverse sine 0.8765 returns an angle of 61 degrees. But remember, there's also another angle in the second quadrant that returns a sine function value of 0.8765. If we sketch this in standard position, there's another angle over here, and this angle would be 180 minus 61, or 119. Question becomes, could this angle also be 119 degrees? And now it can, because if this is 119 degrees, and the other angle that's known is 40, that only sums to 159 degrees, which is less than 180 degrees, so it is possible in this problem to have two different triangles. So what's happening is this side B could be here, or it could also be angled in this direction, making this angle A 119 degrees. Let's go ahead and sketch the second possibility here. So angle A could be 61 degrees for our first solution, and angle A could also be 119 degrees for the second solution. Let's go ahead and stick with our original sketch and determine the length of side C and the measure of angle C. Since we know the sum of these angles must be 180 degrees, that would leave 79 degrees for angle C. Now we have to find the length of side C using the law of sines. So we have the sine 40 degrees divided by 22 must equal sine of C divided by the C. This comes out to approximately 34 centimeters. Here's our first possible solution. Now let's go ahead and finish off the second possible. Again, if this is 119 degrees and this is 40 degrees, that leaves 21 degrees for angle C. And now we need to find the length of side C, finish off our second. So the setup will be similar. We'll have the sine of 40 degrees divided by 22 must equal now the sine of 21 degrees divided by C. Cross multiply, divide by sine 40. Second solution, approximately 12 centimeters. And again, the key to finding this second solution is your given side-side angle where the given angle is acute. When you go to find that second angle, make sure you find that angle that is acute as well as obtuse that has the given sine function value. Once you find this obtuse angle, see if the sum of the angles is more than 180 degrees. If it's not, you do have your second. So you have to set up and solve two different triangles, one with the acute angle and one with the obtuse. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.